Yeah, so my neck is stuck. Sometimes it happens, especially if swing those arms. Especially if you've been like in a multiple car accidents or gotten whiplash or just life injuries in the shoulders, neck, which I've had many. So sometimes it gets a little angry, and that's okay. I'm just gonna work around it today. So a lot of the times when our neck is kind of stuck, I will take my hand and I'll just pull my right ear towards my right shoulder. And I'm gonna rest my hand on that ear, top ear, and then I'm gonna push my ear into the hand or towards the ceiling. And then the hand that's dangling, I'm gonna reach for the floor. Just stretch that neck out a bit. And then I'm going to take my head and just slightly go forward. Back to center, and I'll do the other side. So my left ear gently towards the shoulder. Put my hand on that ear, top ear, and then reach my other hand towards the floor and push my ear into that top hand there. Push towards the ceiling and take a deep breath. Imagine everything relaxing. And then I just bring my head slightly forward. You can't stop a me. I take my chin, I'm gonna go to my right shoulder and to my left shoulder. Back to center. Shoulder rolls. Okay, let's roll forward. Whee! Crunch, 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 crunch. So 2 weeks from tomorrow, I'm going to Mexico for a week. So that means I want to be beach ready. So that means I have to eat really healthy, clean, which I should be doing all the time, but a little extra when you're about to go on a beach. Okay? Hands straight out at the sides. I'm just gonna reach out side to side. Subtly stretching, warming up. So I made this workout days ago for us. I'm gonna try and stick to it, see what happens. Shoulder and neck is kind of mad. I'm not sure. I want to do a burpee. Who would? Right. And a plank, which is what I had planned. So instead, different kind of cardio. So we're going to do 20 seconds of hardcore cardio, as hard as you can go. And then I had a plank set up for that. You can either do the plank or you can do the core hold with me. And the reason I'm doing the core hold is because I don't want to put a lot of pressure on the sore shoulder. Okay? So I'm just going to go right to my timer. So here's your choices. You can either do burpees for 20 seconds, or you could do jumping jacks, standing jacks. Here we go. Any kind of cardio. So you could even just jog as hard as you want. Jog, 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 jog. Get that heart rate up. You could do punches, anything you want, or you could do those burpees. You could do walkout planks. I just want that hurried up for 20 seconds, okay? So now you're either going to a plank or you can do this core hold with me. And I'm only doing this because of my stupid shoulder. So core hold, just holding. You can pump your arms a bit. Pull the 100. We've got a good 40 seconds doing this one. Or you're doing a plank, right? I'm not gonna pump. got a spasm.
No point in pumping those shoulders, but I am gonna hold this core for another 12 seconds. My feet are not on the floor. I got a 45 degree angle with my spine, trying to hold it nice and straight. 2, 1, good. Back to cardio. Back to burpees, or whatever cardio you decide to do. You see if maybe I can do some low jacks here. I'm gonna go low into almost squat position and jump out. Oh, I got 10 seconds, silly me. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. You don't have to jump it, you can walk it. But pick that pace up. Just depends on your body, how hard you want to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Back to that core hold or plank. Some reason you don't want to go to the floor, do push-ups on the wall. Here we go, hold. You want to take it a little further, you can put your arms over your head for your core hold. But you really want to keep that spine nice and straight. Got about 15 seconds. This is just our warm-up that we're doing. There you go. 8 seconds. I was trying to will the beep to come. Okay, I'm gonna hop back up for some cardio. I think this time I'm gonna do butt kickers. Have a sip of water. There's so many different ways to do butt kickers. You just do a gentle row and kick, alternately kick yourself in the butt, or you can make a high impact and run it out. 3, 2, 1. I'm running her out because it's only 20 seconds. I want to get that body warmed up. But if you don't want high impact, just pick up the pace. Whee! All right, back to the core hold or plank. Whee! I can start to feel the. Here we go, and hold. Whew. Nice. If you push that chest forward, you're gonna have that nice, straight spine. Whee. Getting my heart rate up now. I think I'll do high knees next, just to mix it up. But you can do upper body, like, just do punches, but you really want to keep that pace up because it's only for 20 seconds, right? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Hopping up again. Cardio time. Or you could stay on the floor and do mountain climbers if you so desire. Here we go. Almost ready. Oh, I got that stupid shoulder. That's why I'm not doing plank right now, and that's why I'm not doing burpees right now. 8 seconds. But I wanted to show you that even if you got something going on, just work around it. Don't push yourself. Okay, here we go. We need to do high knees, but you could do any cardio you want. It's only 20 seconds. How could you not, right? Here we go. Get ready. We're going right back into either a plank or a core hold. Here we go. 40 seconds. We're just warming up. That's all we're doing. And we'll get into our workout. Whew. 20 seconds. Keep that chest up so you got a nice straight spine if you're doing the core hold. If you're doing a plank, I want a pelvic tilt so you're pushing those hip bones towards your face. Putting tension between the elbows and the toes, right? Pushing each other towards each other. Here we go. Woohoo! Good job. Okay, hop up. It's always good to give yourself a little bit of a break. Have a sip of water. We got one more. Maybe two, who knows? I've lost track already. Okay, cardio again. Let's go. I'm just doing this because my shoulder, I don't want to lift my arms over my head and aggravate the shoulder. It's already mad enough at me. See, so just, I'm just jumping around. You just jump around like a weirdo. Whee! See? Lots of choices. Just want that heart rate up. Here we go, back down. Either a plank. Our core hold again. Here we go. Hold. 40 second hold. Either way. I would totally be planking it. Like I said. You feel any kind of strain or injury, you do not work that area. You stretch the area. You do not work it. Make it worse. 13 seconds. Woo! Beep. This is the weirdest song ever. 3, 2, 1. All right. Do I have any more? I think we got one more round. Yeah. Then we're done. One more round. For some reason, I think my music's a bit low, which is weird. Okay, here we go. This is our last cardio slash plank, and then we're going on to our workout. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm going to go back into butt kickers. You could either do the low impact version or, oops, pardon me. Stop it. Or you could do this one, high impact. Here we go. Just do this a bunch of times. We've got ourselves, now our body's pumping. We're warmed up. And that was our goal. We worked a bit of core while we're doing it. Yay. 2, 1. Right into the very last plank slash core hold. We're doing it for 40 seconds. And we're moving on. Here we go. Hold. Hallelujah. Oh. That was good. I mean, I think my music stopped playing. It's funny because I just turned it up. Have to beat it with a stick. You better start up music or I'm going to beat you with a stick. Oh, 15 seconds. I could just sing. Boop, boop. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go. Good. Good job. Get yourself some water. We're going to get started in that workout. All right. Impressive. Okay. Switching my timer now. We're going to do 45 seconds on, 15 off. And I'm going to see why the music just stopped working, which is odd. Oh, that is odd. Why that stopped. Anyways, okay, so next round, this is what we're doing. Okay, so we're gonna do two movements. First one is cardio, and I want you to go as hard as you can. You could either, the one that I put down is called jump rope, and you're just gonna do like a jump rope like this, like you're actually jumping rope. Or you could do one of the cardios that you just did, right? And then, oops. Sorry, I'm just rebooting the music because it stopped. You know, I've had years now of this technical things falling apart.
And it used to really throw me off. Now it doesn't even affect me. Okay. And then the second one is an airplane deadlift. So I'm going to take one dumbbell. And I'm going to kick out one leg and bring that dumbbell down, okay? We're going to do side, first side one round, and then we'll switch sides. Normally I would have a heavy dumbbell, but again, shoulder issues, I'm going to go nice and light. You can even do it without a dumbbell, but it would look like this. You'll be reaching your arms out and your leg out. You want your body nice and flat. If you need to stand by a wall for balance, go right ahead. So sometimes, some people, I get them to hold on to a broomstick. Whatever works for you. Okay, here we go. Cardio first. Let's get to work on that. You can do the 10 jump rope. I like pretend jump rope because I never miss. It's funny how sometimes things just go and fall apart, like your technical stuff, and you can't figure out why. There's no reason. It's just random. I used to get TELUS in here all the time, trying to figure out what the problems were. One of them said that they thought it was because I was across the street from a high school and they're hogging all the air. Another one said it's because I had a mirrors near my transmitter. It's just, someone's always got some reason. Okay, here we go. So I always like to soften that knee that I'm going to use for balance. I'm going to reach forward. That's it. Reach forward. I'm trying to have a flat back and my leg straight out. I'm just hinging at my hip. Out and forward. Now you can see why you might want to stand by a wall. Put your hand on the wall. Whoops. And I find if I have a bent knee, it protects my lower back and helps me with my balance. Right, here we go. So reach down and stretch that leg straight out. Whew. Sometimes a knee up being as fancy as the... You just take your time and worry more about form than reps. Oops. That's what happens when you're sitting there trying to show off. Alright, so I'm going to do the other side now. I'm trying to keep a flat back when I'm doing this. It's challenging, so like I said, nice. Soft knee, so slightly bent, right? Protecting that lower back. And here we go. Forward. Back. Forward. Back. Cricket. Trying to fight the urge to turn my body out. I want to have a nice, my hips to be parallel as I reach that leg back. Easier said than done, right? Let's just finish the, oops. Balance isn't very good today. This is the naughty side that's been giving me aggravation, and I find it makes a difference. I'm going to reset the timer. We're going to try everything again. And find when the balance in your body's off, sometimes your balance is off. And I'm doing this. I'm not going to give up on showing up for this class just because my shoulder's bugging me. Okay, here we go. Jump rope. Or any kind of cardio. You can do standing jacks, you can do punches, you can just jog on the spot like a football player. Ooh. Or pretend jump rope. My favorite. The only reason it's my favorite is because it gets my heart rate up really good and I can't trip over my imaginary rope. Or can I? If I did, that would be pretty awesome. 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Get ready for my deadlift here, which I'm finding super challenging for balance today. Soft knee. I'm gonna reach the dumbbell down, try and have a flat back with that leg straight out. Here we go. Let's say you have a really bad hip and it really hurts to do that, lift your leg out and back. You could just run that dumbbell down that front leg, put the other leg back, just like this, right? And you could just run your dumbbell down that leg. Then you don't have to kick out. I guess I should have gave you that one sooner. Sorry about that. Just for some people, you got hip issues. It's really hard to kick your foot out. So you can just put the foot, like I said, back and run that dumbbell down your leg. Okay, let's do the other side. So if I wasn't kicking and running the dumbbell down my leg, I still want to keep my hips square and run it down like this. Otherwise, kick that leg back, hinge at the hip, and make sure you all have a soft knee, whether you're doing either one. Sending all those little messages from my brain to my body about balance, reaching out. Eventually your body starts to catch on. Whew. When you feel the balance go off, just reset, start over. And remember, you're hinging at your hip. You are not bending at the waist. Bending at the hip. Okay, one more time. Where are we gonna put this dumbbell, huh? Here we go. So we're going back into your imaginary jump rope or whatever you decided to do for your cardio. I had someone I was training a couple days ago that had her doing this. And then because it's an imaginary jump rope, she was doing tricks with it. Funny girl. Pretend tricks with her imaginary rope. 20 seconds. Whee! That's right. Whee! Good job. Okay. What's next, you say? One more. It's called like an airplane deadlift. Here we go. Soft knee. Remember, if you're not kicking back, you just put that foot back that you're not kicking. Okay, here we go. Whoops, forgot to make my knee soft. Silly me. And I'm bending at my waist, not my hip. I was thinking about too many things, like shopping. What I was gonna make for supper. Nothing. Making nothing for supper. I'm working. I'm gonna make the cook make me something. We have the best grease salad there, I tell you. Whee! Oops! Look at that. My pounds are brutal today. Alright, I'm gonna switch sides. Maybe I should be the one not kicking. Okay, my front leg that I'm putting all my weight on has a soft knee. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna reach forward, hinging at the hip, kicking the leg back, trying to make a nice flat board with my body. And the soft knee just really seems to help with balance. What we're doing is we're working those butt cheeks, trying to give ourselves a nice rounded bottom of our butt. This is for, and balance, of course.
which keeps the brain strong to work on these things. 10 seconds. Don't practice balance. How are you supposed to have good balance? That's what we're doing. We're practicing. Okay, that's 3. Stop. Drink of water. Reset. One more round of something else now. Okay, here we go. So this time we're going to have 3 movements. One you could do either standing or lying down. I'm going to do lying down so I can work on my core. That's the dumbbell to feet. You got to hold one dumbbell and stand and kick like this, or use no dumbbell, or you could lie on your back and touch the dumbbell on your laces and extend your body. Those are some of the choices you could do. If you're one of the ones that you don't want to do any kicking, then you would lie on your back and just keep your knees in your chest, come up, touch those laces, and reach the upper body. Just do an upper body core workout. Okay, so, and the first one is what we call scissor jumps, but of course, not all of us is going to be doing jumping. So I just want you to do a nice gentle switch, okay? So switch, okay? Or any kind of cardio. And then we're gonna do bird dog on the floor. So upper body cardio standing, and then we're hitting the floor. Here we go. Or you could stay standing. You could do push-ups on the wall instead of bird dog. So I'm just jumping forward and back. I'm not doing lunges. I just want my heart rate up. You do not have to jump. You could walk it out, but I want you to be really quick about it. To move those arms, right? Or you could just jump. Scissor jumps. 15 seconds. Or you could dance. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Okay. We're doing bird dog. If you want to stay standing, do some push-ups on the wall. Otherwise, hands and knees. Here we go. Stretching right arm, left leg out. Technically, I guess you could do push-ups on the floor too. Depends. And when you are doing this bird dog, I want you to hold your shoulders and hips square enough that you can balance a glass of water on your back. And if you don't want to go out or twist your body, imagine that you're, whoops, holding a bottle or a glass of water or a spot of tea on your back. Oh, reach. So good for your gluteus medius, stretching out and strengthening the core. Good job. Okay, we're switching now. I'm doing the dumbbell to my laces, or remember the standing one I showed you where you lift one foot up, straight arms, dumbbell to feet. That's the standing version. Otherwise, you can just touch those laces, extend out. If you don't want to extend your bottom part of your body, and you can just do the upper. You're still doing a reverse crunch and extension with those shoulders. I have a very light dumbbell for this just because of mine, and for some reason you don't want to do the upper part of the body, you can totally do just a reverse crunch. So lots of choices based on your abilities. Woo! 2, 1. Good. So, here we go. Starting over. Jump up and do my scissor jumps. Remember, I said you could do any cardio that we've already done that works for you. my pants up. Okay, so remember, you could do it. You could walk it out. Walk it out really fast, swing those arms. You're still getting that heart rate up. Jumper. This one really gets me, even though it's just a little bit of jumping. Gets that heart rate up. Got about 15 seconds. Going to bird dog. V. Three, two, one. Good. Here we go. I took the time. Where'd my time go? Just dicking around with my stupid computer. Here we go. Remember, you're trying to balance that glass of water on your back. Reach and stretch. Today is a really good day for us because we're flushing all those muscles out. Flushing them out with the cardio. 15 seconds. And do that dumbbell feet. Alright, grab that dumbbell. Remember I said you could be doing a standing version. Like. Just that little bit of cardio gets me sweaty a little bit. Then I know I'm in the fat burn zone. Here we go, I'm going to touch my laces. Stand up. Or you could just do a reverse crunch. Or you can do an upper body crunch. Up to you. Seconds. You know, a weird workout today. Maybe I'm just weird-headed. I like to be 100%. I think that's part of it. You know, when you feel a little off, shoot, a little bit. All right. Let's roll up. The resting core. So just stay on the floor or get on the floor if you're not there yet. Here we go. See this one dumbbell I had? I'm gonna slowly, in slow motion, roll down to the floor. Here we go. You're gonna go up, slow motion, all the way down to the floor. Up, slow motion. Have full control. To your best ability. Running that dumbbell up, slow motion, all the way down. Up, slow motion. Back up, slow motion. You really want to work that tummy. Okay, so lower back issues. You can hold this dumbbell in your chest, go side to side. Torso. You got a neck or shoulder issue. That's not an option. I'm going to sit up and do a Russian twist. Here we go. Got the dumbbell in my chest. I'm just turning that torso. The next exercise we're going to do after this one. Going to work that gluteus medius, which is strengthening the lower back for some reason, but it's also going to strengthen the lats and the upper body. So I want you to focus on either the top or bottom. If you can't do one, you're going to do the top. Top, you can do the bottom. We're going to lie on our tummies. Adaptation to Superman's, we're going, when we come up, we're going to come up and bring our elbows down and then drop the legs and the arms back down. That's how we're doing it. You can only do upper body. Just do the lat pull and go back down. Or lower body. Add the lower. Up, down. Lifting my legs up as my elbows come back. Feel your lower back working. If you have a really bad lower back, you just want a little bit of a rest, take it then. Okay, roll back onto our backs. If you can't do this one, I want you to do an upper body crunch. Otherwise, hold your shoulders up off the floor and flutter kick. Ding, 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 ding.
How does it feel when your walls fall down?
Good times.
How does it feel when your love stand found? How does it feel? It's the sweetest sound.
Yeah, so technically you could be doing upper body crunches and just hold those legs still. If for some reason kicking is not an option, or if you've got a really bad neck, then just lie on your back and kick. Protect your neck. Those kicks add up. Okay, so I want you to put your right ankle on your left knee. Now lift that left knee up. And we're gonna pump it towards our face and work our core. And stretch our hip at the same time. Here we go. You want to support your neck again. Or you put your arms at your sides. Whatever works for you. We're just working that tummy, stretching the glute and hip at the same time. It's awesome. Great, core exercise. If for some reason you couldn't do this because pumping your hip like that hurts, then you can just grab that leg and pull it towards your face and stretch the hip out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. I'm gonna switch sides. Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So, starting tomorrow, for me, because I got a 2-week get ready for the beach program I'm gonna do. You can come with me if you like. So, starting tomorrow, no white flour, no junk. We all know what junk food is, right? So you can have whole wheat flour, no white flour. Here we go, 10 seconds. No junk food, no white flour. That's not too hard to figure out. And I want you to up your raw veggies. 3, 2, 1. Good. Okay. Quickly stretched. So I'm gonna grab my right knee, I'm gonna pull it to my chest, straighten out my left leg. Now I'm gonna add a bit of a shoulder stretch to this, just because, obviously, for obvious reasons, issue. So I'm gonna take this knee to 90 degrees. And pull it across my body. So now I'm kind of lying on my side. And I'm pulling that knee to the floor with my hand. And then my top hand is going to go like a goalpost. I'm going to twist that upper body so it can hang towards the floor. Now, not only am I stretching my chest muscles, which cause a lot of shoulder issues if you're really tight in the chest, I am also stretching my thoracic spine. That's the part of the spine along the ribs. I'm just gonna let it hang. The fact that I'm this far from the floor tells me this
part of the issue. It's funny, when you get a spasm in the back of your shoulder, like in your rotator cuff area, you get a big knot, and your neck hurts, you're thinking, oh, you keep going back there, trying to work on that part, but you should work on the front of your body. Probably causing a lot of problems. Alright, let's switch. Go on to our back. I'm going to pull my left knee, my chest, and straighten my right leg down. Drop it across your body, and then take that hand and pull that knee to the floor. My body's going to turn slightly. I want to go in a goalpost position, and then lie back and stretch that chest, front of my shoulder. Oh, this is definitely the issue. Allie, you naughty girl. What have you done? Nice when you find the culprit of your problems. Stretch her out. Sometimes I'll take a lacrosse ball and knead out my chest muscles. I put my arm behind my back and then just knead it against the wall with the lacrosse ball. It works. Surprisingly, my shoulder and arm is on the floor, so that's good. You guys did it! Yay!